Where can you see Asiatic lions?
Gujarat,
Gujarat.
Gir forest.
Okay, my question is whether Asiatic lions are found only in Gir National Park, whether it can be found only in Gir National Park. Okay, in zoos you can see Asiatic lions in some isolated zoos. Can you tell me any other place where Asiatic lions are found naturally in India? Any idea?
Forest.
No, it is found in Gir is a forest. It's fine. Definitely, you can find only in Gujarat. That is true. Can you tell me other than Gir National Park? Gir is a national park and a wildlife sanctuary that is located in the Saurashtra region of Gujarat. Can you tell me any other places whether you can see Asiatic lions in Gujarat?
No, sir. But because it is a endemic species, sir, we found it only on that region.
It is found only in that region, but that is false. See, it is found in, see, highest population of Asiatic lions is recorded in Gir National Park, but surrounding Gir National Park, there are 9 districts. These lions can move into the agricultural pastoral lands in the 9 districts. That is, I'll give you certain reports, don't worry. There are 9 districts which are located in Saurashtra. I'll show you. One minute.
Madhya Pradesh, sir.
No, you can't see in Madhya Pradesh. Only in Gujarat you can see, because lion is regarded as one of the prestigious animal. See, because I can't use my pen. Can I just try once again uploading this? Because I can't use my pen. What is the problem? One second. Home slideshow from the current slide. There is some problem in using my pen. Okay, so this is Gir National Park. Okay, this is Gir National Park. So this area is called the Saurashtra region of Gujarat. Okay, this area is called the Saurashtra region of Gujarat. There are 9 districts: Jamnagar, Junagadh, Amreli, Bhavnagar, Rajkot, and Sundarnagar. These are 9 districts in the Saurashtra region of Gujarat. And for your excitement, it is not only found in the Gir National Park, it is also found in the 9 districts. It can be found because this lion can stroll into the agricultural pastoral lands of the 9 districts in Gujarat. That 9 districts are located in Saurashtra region. Which region? Which region? What is this region called? This is Gujarat, big Gujarat. What is this red color earmarked region called? There are around
7
regions. Here it is located. Gir is located here, but in this 9 districts also, see, lion can stroll. No, if there is no water, it can go into the agriculture pasture. Do you believe in it? Have you seen some tigers from Western Ghats? They are strolling into some areas of the agricultural pockets if there is no water. Have you seen certain elephants strolling into elephants migrating into Eastern Ghats, Western Ghats, elephant migrating into Eastern Ghats? Yes or no? So the lion, tiger, elephant, they are all local domestic migratory species. So it is not only found in the Gir National Park, but it is also found in the 9 districts in the Saurashtra region of Gujarat. It can be found in the agricultural pastoral lands. Are you getting what I'm telling? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Now coming to the lion.
Lion.
Yes. Yes, please. You have any doubts? Can I go ahead with it? Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
So we are going to study about, we have studied some of the endemic birds. Okay. Just leave that chapter. Some birds you have studied. I'll show you this year's 2020 question where they asked for. There was a question about coppersmith barbet. What is coppersmith barbet? It is a bird or an animal? Mammal. Coppersmith barbet. What is coppersmith barbet? I'm not writing because I can't use my pen today. There is some problem. Coppersmith barbet. What it is?
It's a bird.
It's a bird.
A bird, sir.
Yeah, in 2020, this question was asked. There was a question about red start, R-E-D-S-T-A-R-T. It is a bird or a mammal or a reptile. What it is? There was a question.
There was a bird.
Yeah, it is a bird. Red start, coppersmith barbet. This was, see, what are this? They are birds, reptiles or mammals or whatever. See, this was a question in UPSC in this year's prelims. So you can't neglect biodiversity like this. You have to know what is what. Okay, UPSC is not rarely asking questions. They are repeatedly asking questions. That has become a trend. Okay, so I've given certain endemic birds like lesser florican. Lesser florican is an endemic bird to India. True or false? Lesser florican.
True, sir.
Great true, Indian bustard is an endemic bird of India. True or false?
True, sir.
It's endemic to India. Okay. And Nicobar megapod is an endemic bird to India. True or false?
False.
Nicobar megapod is an endemic bird to India. True or false?
False, sir.
What? Is an endemic bird? It is not an endemic bird. I'm asking
it's
about
an endemic bird. True.
It's true. See, Nicobar megapod. This is an endemic bird to India. That is why it came. You see, in the second postal stamp, it is an endemic bird. That is why it has came in the just postal stamp. Bugon locochilla is an endemic bird to India. True or false? Whether it can be found in Sri Lanka? Bugon locochilla. The first bird, Bugon locochilla. Is an endemic bird to India or not?
Yes,
Bugon locochilla. It's an endemic bird. It's found in the northeastern states. Okay. So it's an endemic bird to India. This is that bird. Bugon. What is that? Can anybody pronounce for me?
Bugon locochilla.
Okay. Anyway, it is an endemic bird. See, this can be asked. I'll show you the questions. Because I can't. I can't use my pen, man. There is a problem with the pen. What is that? Okay. Okay, coming to the Asiatic lions. So, if I give you a question like this, Asiatic lions are found in Gir National Park and surrounding 9 districts in the Saurashtra region, the agricultural pastoral lands of the 9 districts of Saurashtra region. True or false?
True, sir.
True, sir.
True, sir.
This statement has taken, yeah, because I will show you some reports which I have taken from MUIF. Say, for example, Asiatic lions are found only in Gir National Park. That is first statement. Second statement is Asiatic lions are found only in the agricultural pastoral lands of the now 9 Saurashtra districts. Then the third option is Asiatic lions are found in the Gir National Park and surrounding agriculture pastoral lands of the 9 districts of Saurashtra region. Which one is true? Now, because I have taken the statement, I have picked the state from an MUIF report. Okay? UPSC will trick you like this. I'll show you. Because why it is found in the 9 districts? Since lion migrates in the agriculture pastoral lands. To find out what are the major feed of lion, what are the major feed, what the lion will eat. Lion will eat grass, whether it will eat grass or deer or buffalo, what it will eat?
Deer, sir.
Yeah, it will eat deer, it will eat buffalo, it will eat many other animals, even it will eat fox also because it is a mega carnivore. See, what happens, you know, in the agriculture pastoral lands, what will be there with the farmers, whether there will be buffalo, cows and other things will be there with them? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
White is moving from the national park to the agriculture pastoral lands to eat grass or to eat the buffaloes of the farmers?
To eat the buffaloes.
Now I will teach you a concept called human-wildlife conflict. This was a UPSC mains question. What is human-wildlife conflict? What is human-wildlife conflict? Human-animal conflict. What is human-animal conflict?
When animals come to human surroundings and try to eat their domestic animals.
Suppose if this lion goes from the Gir National Park, that is his house, it is going to the Saurashtra region of some farmer's field and eating the buffaloes, that is the farmer, and what the farmer will do? It will shoot the lion? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
what sir. Will happen? Whether it will, there will be a conflict happening, that is called the human-animal human-animal war or conflict. What it is?
Conflict.
Yeah, conflict, sir.
Are you getting it? So now there are a lot of problems. Tiger is crawling into the, you know, agriculture pastoral lands of the Saurashtra region. So human animal conflicts are there. Many things are there. Okay, now we are going to study about the tiger. There was a question in this year's UPSC that were asking about the gestation period of elephant. Have you seen that question? There was a question about the gestation period.
Yes,
gestation period. Yeah, okay. Let me ask you, what was your mother's gestation period when she was having pregnancy? It was 20 months or 30 months?
9 months.
9 months.
9 months. So, okay, tell me, what is the gestation period of an elephant? That was a UPSC question this year. How many of you have referred
to
it?
2 years.
2 years.
2 years, sir.
Have you seen the UPSC question papers?
Yes, sir.
Everybody, have you seen this question? There was a statement about this animal, the gestation period of. Have you seen it? Yeah. So, okay, anyway, I'll come to that thing. You have to refer and tell me about this gestation period in the next class, okay? Okay. Anyways, now we have to learn something about lion, because, you know, UPSC sometimes will ask certain questions which are very trivial. Trivial means what is trivial? What is trivial questions? Trivial, T-R-I-V-A-L.
Tricking.
No. Trivial means non-conventional questions. Trivial questions. That is non-conventional. See, what the hell UPSC is asking about the gestation period, even gestation period of elephant? What is, why they are asking gestation period of, say, for example, these are all not nonsense questions. Do you feel like that? Such age-old professors, they are asking, see, you are all going to the future administrators, they are asking questions about elephant. Do you believe that it's not a conventional questions, right? It's a typical questions. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see, UPSC sometimes behaves like an idiot. See, they'll be asking certain questions which are not relevant at all. They're called trivial questions. So what I want is, I want everybody to write all these things. Sometimes next time they'll be asking about the lifespan of tiger. They'll be asking lifespan of lion. What is the lifespan of lion? How many years lion will live?
18 to 20 years.
So you just keep writing it. Keep writing it. Okay. The female will be like a solid around like 100 to 120 kg. It's fine. It's like, just write this. Have you written this? What is the status? IUCN status? Is it endangered or critically endangered?
Endangered.
Can you tell me what is the IUCN status of tiger?
Endangered.
I've taught you all Ramayana and endangered. So lion and tiger belongs to endangered category. See, before 2010, you know, this lion was critically endangered. Critically means very endangered. But after 2010, the population, when Modi started becoming the prime minister, every reports, see, not after 2000, yeah, after 2010, see, when Modi is becoming, he is trying to show off like Modi ji. Okay, I have to just give reference. When Modi ji became the prime minister, he started showing off. The tigers are increasing, the lions are increasing. Now Modi ji is getting a lot of credits. Okay, so after 2010, the population started increasing. So IUCN categorized after coming of the Modi ji. They categorize from critical endangered status to what status?
Endangered status.
Okay, don't forget, lion and tiger belongs to extinct in the wild. What status it has?
Endangered.
Okay, don't forget it. Okay, so now I want everybody to write this, because can you tell me when was Project Lion launched? Can anybody tell me when is Project Lion launched? You guys have
2020.
Are you all, when it, can you tell me the exact date? I'll give you a gift if you are telling me the exact date. Don't Google. Be true to yourself. Don't know? That means
September 14th.
No, man. See, that means you guys are not reading Hindu newspaper at all. See, August 15, Mr. who is this guy? Mr. Modi ji, August, see, the Modi ji is having one cap. What he is delivering, what speech he is delivering? Can you tell me, recall and tell me? Modi ji is having a cap and he is having like that everything was there. He was can you tell me when you would have seen this guy in this attire?
15 August.
Have you seen on 15th August?
Independence Day.
Yeah, Independence Day on 15th August, Mr. Modi ji told, "I am going to launch Project Lion and Project another one more project is there for the conservation." If you are telling this, I'll
Dolphin.
Go on Google. Okay, great. Project Dolphin and Project Lion. I am going to launch on August 15, 2018. True or false?
False.
False.
2020.
See, you guys are not reading Hindu newspaper. Are you all reading it?
Yes.
See, then why could not raise this? Because Project Lion was one of the most fundamental and crucial thing. Why Project Dolphin? Why Project Dolphin was launched? Why? What is the national aquatic animal of India?
River dolphin.
Which river dolphin? It's Gangetic river dolphin is the national aquatic animal of India. When it was declared national aquatic animal? When Gangetic dolphin was declared?
October 5, 2010.
Okay, so Mr. Modi ji gave a promise. I am very much dedicated for the biodiversity conservation of India. I am going to launch Project Lion. On August 15, 2020, he made a big mess. So 2020 is very, very important. So before studying about the Project Lion, study about what has happened recently. Can you tell me, there was a census record which was launched in 2020. 2018, there was a census record of what? Which was launched. We studied about some estimation report. Hello?
Tiger report.
Okay, can you tell me 2020 there was a census, great census report. How many years tiger report is published? How many years the tiger census is carried out in India?
Every four years.
Can you tell me how many years lion census are carried out in India? Come on, tell me. In how many years lion census is carried out in India? 10 or 15?
5,
sir.
Great. Every 5 years. So let me, 2020, another report of the census was also released by MEOF. That report was Lion Census Report 2020. Can you tell me when was the previous census done?
2015.
Okay. Can you tell me when was it? 2018? One second.
Okay. ഒരു ചെറിയ രണ്ട് ഇത് ഹോൾ കിട്ടാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടായിരുന്നു രണ്ട് സ്ക്രൂ അടിച്ച് സ്ക്രൂ ചെയ്യാൻ ഇവിടെ ഇവിടെ രണ്ട് സ്ക്രൂ ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടിയായിരുന്നു ഞാനുണ്ട് ഞാനൊരു 11 മണിയാകുമ്പോഴത്തേനെ ഫ്രീ ആവത്തുള്ളൂ എനിക്ക് ഒരു ക്ലാസ് ഉണ്ട് ഓക്കെ താങ്ക് യു താങ്ക് യു ഞാൻ വിളിക്കും ഓക്കെ
സോറി ഫോർ ദി ഇന്റർപ്രിറ്റ് ഇൻ ഇൻ വാട്ട് ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇന്ററപ്ഷൻ റൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ്സ് ഇന്ററപ്ഷൻ വാസ് ഇറ്റ് എൻ ഇന്ററപ്ഷൻ ഫോർ യു Okay. Anyway, sorry for the interruption. So, can you tell me? So, the lion census is long is done every
5 years.
5 years.
Okay. When will the next tiger census estimation report? Which will be when will be the next tiger estimation report? Will be published.
2025, sir.
No. I am asking about the tiger. Yes. Let me know your name, please. Tiger is 2018 was the last report. So the next every tiger report is published every
4 years.
2022. Okay. Can you tell me? Okay. Project Lion, the census report was published in 2020. Can you tell me when will be the next Lion census report published? Will be published?
2025.
Is the concept clear for you?
Yes, sir.
See, let me tell you, rather than studying everything, make certain things. What is that? Paste, paint, and what? I used to tell something. Paste, paint, and nail. What is nailing? What is nailing? You don't know? Yeah. What you have to do is, you have to, certain facts and certain concepts, you have to paste, paint and nail in your heart and mind. Okay? Don't lose that. So how many years? 5 years and 4 years. Okay. Now coming back. So everybody write this. So this, so to come to the last thing, Project Lion 2020, we will be studying about the history, about what are the conservation effort. See, this is all basically about biodiversity conservation. Okay. The biodiversity, how the biodiversity is conserved. Okay. So lion is a biodiversity. It's like a, it's a very primordial importance in the biodiversity conservation, since it is an apex species. It's in a, it's a top carnivore, everything. So everybody write about these things. These topics we are going to discuss. We'll be discussing about the lion census. Then we'll be discussing about, hope the screen is visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. We'll be studying about the Asiatic Lion Reintroduction Project of 2004. Then we'll be studying about the Asiatic Lion Conservation Project of 2018. Then we'll be studying about the Project Lion 2020. To study the Project Lion 2020, we have to understand what has happened in the field of conservation of lion before. Okay. So first thing we'll be studying about the lion. What we'll be studying? Have you all written this? I want everybody's pen to move.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Written? So we'll be studying about the first, today we'll be studying about only about lion census, because I have 30 minutes left. Can I go with the next one? Hope you are all. So just underline this word, yes, reintroduction. Sir. I just want everybody to underline the word reintroduction. I want everybody to underline the word conservation. So I want everybody to write this years, 2018, 2004 and 2020, lion census of 2000. So it is carried every 10 years, right? Lion census.
5 years.
Okay. Now I'll tell you some story. Okay. In 2018, in the month of October, what happened? You know, in the Gir National Park, around 24. How many dozens? 24 lions. That means how many dozens?
2 dozens.
Yeah, 2 dozens of lions started dying. Suddenly, it is found only in the Gir area and in the Saurashtra landscape, agriculture landscape. So started. See, if 23 lions died, approximately 2 dozens of lions died. So if the lions die, what will happen? What will happen? It was because of a certain disease. If all the lions die in India, what will happen? What will happen?
Destruction of
them. There will be no grass.
Yeah, there is, see, what is Gujarat thinking? No, Gujarat is telling that I will not give you any lions. I will not give you any lions to any national park or wildlife sanctuary. I'll give to Sioux, no problem. You, that is a, like a money-making business for you. But I will not give to any national park or wildlife sanctuary. I will not be able to, I will not allow you to reintroduce this animal, because, see, because it is the prestige of Gujarat. The lion man, who is the lion man? Approximately, I can call Modiji. Okay. So he is very much, these people are very much proud that, see, any students from Gujarat in my class? Is there any students? Okay. Is there? I think no one, right? So if I'm just, okay. So what happened in October 2020, in 2018, many tigers, lions started dying. It was because of 2 diseases. One was a viral disease, other was a parasitic disease. So can you tell me what was the viral disease name?
CDV virus.
CDV virus, yes, canine distemper virus. So I'll told this, so these were the 2 viruses. One is the viral disease, and babesiosis is a parasite disease. Okay, I want everybody to write this. UPSC can ask questions. Canine distemper disease is a viral disease which started, see, the 23. So after doing the postmortem of the lions, whether the postmortem will be done for the lions, tigers, if they die, whether it will be done or not. Whether it will be done or not.
Yes, sir.
Yes, of course, they have to do. They are also, you know, see, as per the Constitution of India, there is a provision that wild animals and the animals and the wildlife has to be conserved. Okay, so they are given even in the directive principles of state policy, as well as in the article number, I forgot the article number, I think 226 or something like that. In the article 226, the importance of the wildlife is being proclaimed. So they are giving equal importance of all the treatments and the, you know, as like that of humans, right? So what were the disease which happened, which led to the death of the lions in the Gir National Park?
What were the disease?
I want you to tell. Come on, can anybody help me out? What were the diseases?
Canine distemper.
Canine distemper disease. Canine distemper disease. That is a viral disease. Can you tell me what is the parasitic disease which led to the death of? Babesiosis. Okay, just pronounce it. Just make it very rhyming. Can you just help me out? What is that? Babesiosis, right? Am I right or wrong? It is caused by Babesia, a parasite. It's a parasitic disease. Can anybody pronounce for me? What is that? Why I'm making you to pronounce, you know, you'll not forget it. Can anybody help me? Help me out, Yogesh. Can you help me out? What is that?
Babesiosis.
Okay, fine. Anyway, so what were the diseases? Canine distemper disease. You should not forget CDV. CDV, canine distemper disease, is a viral disease which led to the death of tigers in Mudumalai National Park. True or false?
False.
Babesiosis. It's a parasitic disease which led to the massive death of fox in some maybe it can be, but I can't go with it because it can be also because it's a common disease for animals. But anyway, it's like babesiosis and canine distemper disease as per our records, that is to the lions. Okay, what is the status of lions? What is this status?
Endangered, sir.
As per why WPA, true or false?
False, sir.
Okay. Can you tell me the status of lions before 2010? It was endangered.
Critically endangered.
Why from critically endangered it became endangered? It became less pronounced in conservation. Why? The population is not increasing. Yeah. Okay. What is the WPA status?
Schedule one.
Can you explain to me what is CITES? Expand CITES. What is CITES?
Convention on International
Trade. Great.
So you have written this? Done or not? You have written, no? There is no need to write all these things. Have you written this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, have you written this? Okay. Have you written this? Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I've told you about the habitat. What is the habitat? So you have to write this. Asiatic lions are found in the protected areas. That is a protected area. What is the protected area? Which national park and wildlife sanctuary?
Gir National Park.
And the agro-pastoral landscapes of Saurashtra covering the 9 districts of Gujarat. What are the 9 districts? Porbandar, Jamnagar, Rajkot, Junagadh, Amreli, Bhavnagar, and this two areas are also there. Okay. No need to write this. You have to write this. Are you writing this? Are you writing? Yes, you have done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do I need to wait for anyone? No. Now, coming to the Asiatic lion. Can you tell me what was the methodology which was used for estimation of tiger census? Which was the methodology which was used? What type of census was carried out? Whether it was PACMAR, do you remember PACMAR census was there? Then what was the other census? What was the method?
Camera trap, M stripes.
Do you remember all those things? Are you all revising what I'm teaching?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, revise at least once in a month. Okay. So just write this. The census about the lion census, just write only the second statement. Census is conducted once in every 5 years. This year it was delayed due to lockdown, but on October 6th and 7th, sorry, 5th and 6th, not October, August 5th and 6th, I think. It is the full moon, August, one second. Let's get it out. Yeah, August 5th and 6th. June 5th and 6th only this year it was conducted. Can you tell me how the tigers can be estimated? Can you tell me? There was camera trap can be okay, fine. Any other methodology do you feel? What methodology?
Drone.
A drone, it's very difficult because it's a forest area, because drones will get smudged in different areas. It's very difficult to use drones because manual estimation only is possible in the caves, because the terrain is different. You will not have a plain area. Drones will not move. Very difficult. Any other?
Sir, pugmark.
Pugmark can't be used because the pugmarks of lions are very difficult for estimation, because it resembles in many other aspects. Tigers, it's very, 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 pugmarks is very vibrant pugmark, but for lions, it can't be used. It can't be used.
Sir, any method to find roads?
Sir, cataract.
Cataract method. It's a type of camera trapping that can be used, but can you tell me a specific method which was used in tiger for lion senses? There is a specific, that is called the block counting method. What is that method called for the lion estimation? See, these are all very, very important, my dear friends, because this was done in, it is there in the newspaper. It can be asked. What is this method called? What was the method which was used for the estimation of the lions in India by MEOF?
Block counting method.
It's called the block counting method. I'm going to teach you what is block counting. Before that, in 2020, how many? See, in 2015, what is the tiger number? What is the lion number?
523, sir.
2020? 674. There is an increase or decrease?
Increase, sir.
How much percentage is increase? There is an
29%.
Yeah, approximately 28%. There is an increase of the tigers. Lions. How many lions are there in India as per 2018 census? Yeah, sorry, tigers.
Da-da-da-da-da. 2967.
Great. 2967. How many lions are there in India now?
674.
Okay, now I'll teach you what is block counting method. Okay, I think there are just around 10 minutes for you, me to wind up. Should I just continue with the classes, or should I just give you a motivation tip?
Motivation, sir.
Okay, anyway, just 2 minutes, I'll just continue with this. Okay, everybody just write this. Key figures of this year's census. Total estimated tiger number is 674. 2015, it was 523. There is a 28% increase. Okay, now about the distribution of the land, I tell you the protected area and the agro-pastoral landscapes of where? Of Tamil Nadu.
Saurashtra region.
What was in 2015? What was the area which was occupied by the lions? 2015. How much area?
22,000 square kilometers.
What is the area which is in 2020 as per the estimates?
30,000 square kilometers.
How much percentage of increase is there in the distribution is there in this year?
36%.
Are you understanding what I am teaching? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Keep writing this. These are all things have taken from the report of the lion census this year 2018 is available in the MOEF and CC. What is that MOEF and CC website?
Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change.
Yeah, great. So you have all written this. So that lions are found only in the protected area of Gir National Park. True or false? Asiatic lions are found only in the protected area of Gir National Park. True or false? What is the answer for this question?
Agro-pastoral landscapes of Saurashtra.
And protected area of yeah. Are you getting what I'm teaching? Are you understanding? Yes or no? Is there any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
No doubts. Okay, great. Okay, the remaining, I'll just take 10 minutes to give you motivational capsules. I think you require that. So I'll continue with this tiger census in the next class. Then we'll be studying about, so ultimately for what studying, what we are studying all these things, tiger census, the introduction, reintroduction program, conservation project. After that, to study what?
Project Lion.
Project Lion, we are studying all these things to find out the lineage, the history behind the lion conservation in India. Okay? So what we'll be studying? We'll be studying all these things. We'll be studying lion census, block counting method I'll be teaching you, then Asiatic lion, reintroduction project. What is reintroduction project? Can you tell me what is reintroduction? Where is the Asiatic lions found only in India? Only in Gujarat, right? So it can be introduced because if any disease is happening, whether everything will be dying, no. So it will be lacking Asiatic lion. So it's a problem for India. So it has to be reintroduced into other national parks. That is, I'll teach you about all these things later. Okay.